Hi. As she said, I'm Sai Prasanth. I'm a graduate of IIT Madras, 2013 pass out. So, see, this is something like people say, think out of the box, in which they say, think different. Okay, but today I'm saying, come out of the box. Okay, so I'll just go through. So how did my journey start? So it all started from a single thought. So I was inspired by a TED video where Tandy Newton, she talked about embracing otherness, like how it will be if you are somebody else. So from that thought, I took on an adventure to reach Everest base camp without taking any money and without any identity. So that's what the adventure was. So I told it to a couple of friends. They were saying, okay, what? It's rubbish. Okay. Then I told to my parents. They were saying, okay, fine, try out. And I had a job after college. It was like a 22 lakhs job and stuff. So it was, okay, I had a month time to go for the job. So my father said, okay, you can go, but you have to come back in a month. So the challenge was to go to Everest base camp in 30 days. And I did some research and I needed around 40,000 rupees to go there. So I've started from the house. I went out without any money, without anything, but my father told you should have the mobile. Okay, I had a mobile. I went out. So I didn't know where to go initially. So I went out to a railway station. So after walking after walking for a while, it started feeling hungry. Okay, I was thinking, okay, should I go back home? Okay, so it started like that, but I pushed myself, like, okay, do something. So that journey started, and it went through very, very painful stuff. I thought it would be so much fun, but the reality was it was very painful. Like, to be somebody else is very difficult. And when you are in a situation where you don't have food, where you don't have a place to stay, all the adventure is gone there. So it was all about earning money for food and staying at a place. So the journey started like that. So after some time, it happened to me that I was in a situation where I was causing harm to people for my adventure. So I turned out to be a very bad person. So I called my mother that day. I was crying. I said, Mom, I've completely changed. In just 1 week, I've completely changed. I was about to harm a girl, okay, for my adventure. My mom said, this is a famous movie dialogue, I guess. You are not who you are. You are what you do that matters. So she said, don't do it. Even though you are different kind of person, whatever you do is what matters. So that's when I stopped doing that and I continued the journey. I'm not going to say how I earned money right now, but I went to Gorakhpur to cross the border and go to Nepal. So I was beaten up by people there, by thugs. I got robbed. I tried to save my phone. Okay, by forcefully I saved my phone. And I thought, okay, it's done, let's go back home. So I was coming back home in a train, in a general compartment. And then something else happened. It was something amazing. I made money in the train in just 18 hours of the journey. And there was a small guy who inspired me to go back and pursue my adventure. So I started back again. And the second part of the journey was amazing, obviously. Everest base camp, wow, it was amazing. And after reaching Nepal, I had enough money to reach the base camp, but I didn't have enough money to come back. So I was thinking what to do. So I found a woman from US who was willing to do the base camp. Like, it's like you go there in Kathmandu, you try partner with somebody and go and come back. So I thought, okay, I heard that she was like 60-year-old. From US, I thought, okay, I can be a porter to her. I can make some money out of it. I can have my meals and stuff. It will be fine. But then what happened? I met her. She was doing 60 push-ups in a minute. Okay. And I was surprised. She was from US Army, it seems. So that lady at the end, she is the one. So she was very, very strong. She was stronger than me, actually. So like, it was supposed to be a 14-day camp, but I didn't have much money. So I covered it in 5 days. I reached base camp in 5 days. And in that 5 days, I needed a porter. Okay. Because you can see me, I'm not strong. Okay. So I needed a porter, and it turned out to be completely different of what I thought it will be. So after 30 days, so finally I saw the Mount Everest. It was like from the base camp, you can see Mount Everest peak, not exactly from the base camp, en route to the base camp. So that was that. And the final day when I was going to base camp, I was alone. The lady, she had some headache, and she had to rush and go back. She had a flight. So I went alone, and there were small avalanches happening, and nobody was there around. It was just me and Mount Everest. So that was an amazing feeling to be there, and I didn't know if I'll be coming back. So, but then I finally came back. It turned out to be an amazing journey and painful also. The first part was very painful. It was greed. I had greed because I wanted to achieve something, and I was poor. I didn't have money. So it was this journey, it completely changed my view about life. So basically, this I've put it on a book. Like I named it Mom, I Know What I'm Doing. So in 2016, probably I'll be publishing on somewhere, Amazon or somewhere. Yeah. So from this journey, like, people go out to these kind of adventures to know about themselves, who you are and stuff. But after this journey, what I learned was, it was not about who you are. Adventure is about what you can do. Or knowing yourself is about what you can do rather than who you are. Because you are not defined at all. There is no meaning to life. You have to create it. So, yeah. So what next? After this, and after seeing Mount Everest, obviously it was amazing. So I wanted to pursue something bigger. So I did this in December, immediately, it's the same year. Yeah, I took my job. I went to Africa. I was living in Kenya for a while. Then I had this opportunity to climb Mount Kilimanjaro. It is the highest mountain of Africa. And I wanted to do it on my birthday. Everybody laughed at me. Look at you. I was 94 kgs. My weight was 94. You can't do it. Those African people were very strong. They were saying, even we can't do it, how can you do it? So that was it. So that was on my birthday, morning, 8:30. Sound is not there, I guess. Yeah, so I was at the peak at 8:30 in the morning on my birthday. That was like, you know, I was feeling it was amazing. I was very happy, and that's when I realized strength doesn't come from physical capability. It was a famous quote also by somebody, but it comes from your willpower probably. Yeah, so that's when I reached there. So after reaching there, I was on cloud 9. I was sure that I'll be doing other mountains as well. So that's how it was. So the next year, on the same day, for my birthday, I quit my job in Africa, it was done. I went to South America. I went to climb a mountain called Aconcagua. It is 6,962 meters. That is second highest in 7 summits after Mount Everest. So I went and I pursued it. But then what happened was, at 6,500 meters, there was a wind storm. So it was like 100 kilometer per hour wind, minus 37 degrees temperature was there. So everybody said, you have to leave, you have to go back. So I was with a team of 14, and my guides and people, they said, you have to go back. I was actually fighting with them. I came from India, it's not possible, I cannot come again. No, I want to go up. But then they forced me to go down. While coming down, yeah. Also, they rescued us from using a helicopter from the base camp. So, but while coming down, I got an injury. I picked up an injury to my leg. And it turned out to be good afterwards, the reason is. So the one thing I realized after this trip was, not everything is under your control. So basically the weather, it was not under my control. This was my first defeat probably, because I used to challenge this and it was my first defeat. And the reason why I do on my birthday is, like, when I am there on the top, I feel very insignificant. Birthdays are meant to be very significant for people, like you are the special person on that day. But when I am there on the top, like, you see the views and you are utterly insignificant that day. So after this leg injury, it helped me somehow. So the reason why I picked up the injury was, I didn't have proper footwear. So then I came back, we just discussed like why, what. So then we came to know that there is development in technology in lot of ways, but there is nothing where there is something custom fit that is done to people. Like, we don't do custom fit products for us. We build spacecrafts, we build lot of stuff, but to build custom fit products to mass people, it's very difficult, because everybody has to go to somebody and take some like impression of that person and build products for them. But then we came up with a technology in my current startup. This is a technology we are patenting, first in India. So what we are doing is, we are taking 3 pictures of the foot and we are doing 3D reconstruction of the foot, and then we are designing the product, and everything happens in the software. And we are launching this product for doctors. We are not launching it directly to the consumer, because it is a premature market. So we are launching it to doctors, so orthotic doctors and podiatrists, so that they'll order insoles for their patients. So my adventure of this adventure, it brought me this. And this has good value. A similar startup from Canada, it raised $3 million last month, and probably we'll also be raising decent amount for this idea. And in May we'll be launching this product. And so after this, like, adventure has become a passion to me. It's not like I'll do it once in a while. I probably do my work and adventure like half probably. So it's almost half. You can see, like, I was diving with sea lions, and those were again sea lions. This is a small baby elephant which I am fostering. It is in Kenya. And these were penguins, and I was going with tribes of Maasai tribes and people and stuff. And it is amazing to be there, because you need to live life completely apart from work. And obviously, I want to build a technology company. There are gods here, but at the same time, I want to do this too. So what next? So I am attempting 7 summits. Last December, I was supposed to go to Antarctica again for my birthday, but I could not raise enough money for it. I could raise $28,000, but I needed 40. At the same time, Chennai got floods. I was living in Chennai. Then I got robbed. So a lot of stuff happened, and I couldn't go this year. I mean last year. So after that, I've decided to do a grand slam. So I'll be doing almost 4 in this year, and probably if I become slim, I'll attempt Everest next year, because all 6 summits I can attempt. I mean, all mountains of 6 continents I can do with this body, but Everest I can't do. I know my limits actually. And one more thing I wanted to do after this 7 summits challenge is to experiment something on religion. People just talk about religion, and somebody supports some religion, somebody opposes something and something, but nobody experiments anything different. So there I'll be doing something soon, not now, probably next year and stuff. And my mission is to reach Mars and climb something called Olympus Mons. That is the highest mountain that has been discovered so far in our solar system. So that I want to climb. I don't know how, but probably that thought itself will bring me an opportunity to do that. And probably my talk, it's all about adventure. So I just say that we all need a bit of adventure in our lives. It need not be mountains or scuba diving or something. It should be something which you don't do regularly. It should be something out of your comfort zone. So that's why I said come out of the box. Because when you come out of the box and do something new, one thing is you will have happiness, sheer joy of doing something new. Because that's what I believe, that's what we like it. That's what we love. Doing something new or exploring something new is something we love. At the same time, it's not about just exploring something new. It is about exploring yourself also. What you can do and what you can't do. And then you can aim for something bigger. Just like I said, Mars, right? I don't know how, but probably in my lifetime, I'll be doing it for sure. And yeah, and one more thing is, adventure breaks all our beliefs. What we believe, see, I was believing that I can't do anything. But when I climbed Kilimanjaro, now I believe that I can climb other mountains as well. So that's what happens when you do adventure. It's a hard way of learning about yourself. Okay, and in all our busy lives, we don't have time for this. But I believe everybody should take some time to pursue adventure. That's something. Yeah. Thank you so much. And fortunately, life is not a linear transformation. If we do things monotonously, it will be a linear transformation. But if we pursue adventure sometimes, then it won't be a linear transformation. It will be leaps. We don't know what happens next. Thank you so much.